four tenure line faculty and three or four other non-tenure line faculty, so we've got a group of about six or seven total. As far as the sort of infrastructure of the department, we're basically kind of splayed out in different locations. We have a couple of research labs at the Institute for Sensory Research, and that's because they have animal facilities there. So two of our faculty are involved with that kind of research, and they're soon to be moving to the Life Sciences Center, so we're really looking forward to that. They'll be closer, better facilities and so forth. And we think that's important because having a sort of cohesive unit is an important thing, and having these folks close by. We also have a couple of labs here in the Women's Building, both of which are, they're being rebuilt. That's a good thing. Upstairs, the major lab is referred to as the Human Performance Lab, and that's sort of a large space, a kind of a shared resource space, where we do all of our applied human type research. So when you picture people riding on bikes or running on treadmills with valve systems and, you know, catheters and things like that, that's what happens up there. At least historically, that's what's happened up there. And that will be refurbished in the sense that we're getting new floors and drapes and so forth. But as we recruit new faculty, whatever research, you know, foci they bring to the mix, will, you know, those things will start to happen up there. Our second lab space is just across this wall. It used to be the musculoskeletal laboratory. So there's a bunch of, leg extension, knee extension, muscle kind of things in there. But that's being refit to reflect my research interests, which is high altitude and hypoxia. So it's basically going to become kind of an environmental research lab with the ability to replicate high altitude conditions, so we can sort of put a chamber in there, and that chamber will be able to put a lowered oxygen level into the chamber and replicate high altitude conditions. So that's what's going on next door. Ernie Davis was, I guess, conceptualized as a kind of a show place for teaching. Prior to that facility, it had always been a priority of this department to make sure that our students were exposed to, you know, laboratory type activities. And you can see that in the way that the cornerstone course of the department, the physiology of exercise, is structured. It is a lecture-based course, but the other half of it is laboratory. And the way that was always put in place was by having students come to the research labs, which presented, I guess, certain problems to coordinate, you know, to have a class of 10 or 15 students in a research lab where there were ongoing projects and so forth. So, the original concept, and these my predecessors, was that there should be a dedicated teaching space. And a lot of exercise science departments have this. You know, it's really a laboratory dedicated to the teaching of exercise physiology. So you can have students come in and run through exercise protocols themselves, as opposed to, you know, being given a demonstration. Because if it's your research equipment, you know, you don't want 20 student hands on the keyboard. Because if it breaks, then you're in trouble. So I think that's what Ernie Davis was intended to be, was you know, to really have this teaching space available for our students. And the whole idea is, you know, really to, you know, just to put this in sort of straightforward terms, you can teach a student how to do a VO2 max test, an aerobic capacity test, and typically what happens is they walk in and you select a volunteer, and the student gets up on the treadmill and teaching assistant or professor wires them up and runs the computer and says, look at this number and look at this number and look at this number. But the ideal way to do this is to have various stations where students can do these things themselves. And that's what we're working towards over there.